Hi, everybody. This is Chris from ChristopherJ.net. That's actually www.christopher-j.net. Welcome to my podcast. This is a new song that I'm releasing called Angeline the Baker. So I have a book that I've had left over from the days when I attempted to learn to play violin or fiddle, and I never got rid of the book because I love a lot of that music that's in there. I really like those old fiddle tunes. So this is my recording of the song Angeline the Baker, and it's an arrangement that I created based on this old fiddle tune. And that song, from what I've read, was kind of loosely based on another song called Angelina Baker that was written by Stephen Foster back in 1850 for the Christy Minstrels. They say that the Stephen Foster song lamented the loss of a woman slave. This was prior to the Civil War, so 1850, to put it in perspective. And the melody of the fiddle tune, Angeline the Baker, is a little bit different than the Stephen Foster song. So in my arrangement, I added some other instrumentation and spiced it up a little bit and added a bit of a country beat. Hope you like it. Also, I found a little note in doing some of my research on the history of the song on a site called mudcat.org. Someone wrote that there is a recording of Angeline the Baker on the Folk Legacy CD, The New Golden Ring, 5 Day Singing, and the lyrics are the same as what's in the Digital Tradition database. And here's what the CD notes say. This is an old Eck Dunford tune with possible Negro origins. Frank George, a fiddler from West Virginia, calls it Angeline and gives it Scottish overtones. In some parts of West Virginia, it's called Angeline Baker, thus causing some friction between fiddlers when it's played. I can imagine a big fiddler fight going on. The tune was played only as an instrumental, and the words are a relatively recent addition. There is a Stephen Foster song called Angelina Baker, and the tune may have some derivation from that, or perhaps it's the other way around. Notes by Sarah Gray. Anyway, I hope you like it, and if you want to buy a copy, you can see the music store page on my website, or look me up on CD Baby.